love your mind. So a few days ago, I was able to finish watching Shadow and Bone. This is a new Netflix original series, which is 8 episodes long, each episode being about 45 minutes to an hour, most of them closer to the hour mark, actually. And it is based off of the very popular novel series of the same name. So Netflix does do a really good job adapting all of these fantasy stories and fantasy books into live action television series, which they've been able to do with The Witcher, Castlevania, if you want to count that in there, but they're just doing an absolute amazing job in the fantasy series. So without further ado, let me get into my review for the first season of Shadow and Bone on Netflix. So right off the bat, I will say that I have never read the fantasy series, but after watching the trailers, I was really intrigued by the world that they're creating here, and I want to learn a lot about it. And we do get to learn a lot about it through some fantastic world building that this show is able to bring to us almost right off the bat. That's where this series takes place. A quick little synopsis of what goes on is that in the land where this takes place, there is this thing known as the Shadow Fold, and it is basically like this ginormous wall of pretty much impenetrable darkness that has been cast upon the lands almost centuries ago, and anyone who ventures into it mostly doesn't make it out alive, because there is a ton of monsters inside the fold that are just ginormous, winged, fast, terrifying creatures who just absolutely smoke anything that goes through there. And travel through it is extremely limited, and they do it mostly by basically like these large boats that have wheels on it, and they push it through. Try not to use any lights, because that's how these creatures tend to track prey. But this has basically just been used, this ginormous fold, as a barrier between a bunch of different nations who are at war with one another. A lot of them use this fold, this barrier, as a weapon as well too, which we get to learn a little more down the series. But we follow mostly a girl named Alina, who is an orphan who discovers that she has a unique power of light, which is able to penetrate the darkness, kill a bunch of creatures, and she becomes humanity's hope to unite the kingdoms, destroy the fold one day, and like I said, just basically bring peace back to the world. But there are others in this world who want to use that power for their own destruction, and like I said, just basically use the fold and Alina's powers to their own advantage, to just basically overtake everything and become rulers. Of course, that was my quick little synopsis to get you up to speed if you want to like watch this show. But there is, like I said, just so much world building and a lot of depth, and some really fantastically written characters in this show. Some of the best like character building and character studies that I've seen from like a season one of a show in a long, long time. You get to learn a lot about them and see trauma, responsibility, so much come into their lives that changes each and every single one of these characters and makes, like I said, characters that I was falling in love with by the end of the first season, which I don't find happens too often with me. In a lot of shows, it's just really great in terms of where it places its characters, having them mesh together, learn from one another in ways that either really strengthen their relationship, but most of the time test them in terms of if they're going to be friends or foes. In so many ways, even like lovers at the beginning of the series get their relationships tested in so, so many ways. Nations who were once friends with one another are shaped by events way off in the distance that threaten their own political landscapes. And there's just so much that's taken into account, not just on the human scale, but it goes to nation scale, political scale, scale monsters that come into this too. It's really, really awesome. And it's just a really fantastically well-written, well-paced show that does a lot in terms of character study to really, like I said, make characters that you care about and you want to see more and learn more about each and every time they're on the screen. There isn't a standout character for me. They're all really fantastically written, even the side characters. There's two big story arcs. One is with Alina learning the true nature of her powers, and the other one is basically a group of ragtag bandits who steal a bounty to go and capture basically a source of power for one nation to bring it back alive, this source of power, and they're gonna get paid a lot. But it turns out to be something that's way bigger than themselves, and the mission changes based off of, like I said, the political landscapes, the folds, and just the responsibility, not just to get the job done, but the responsibility of what doing this job is going to mean for the greater world outside of them, and what completing the mission would actually mean for them in the long run. And like I said, just every single sequence is so well thought out and so well prepared, and it makes for an amazing fantasy series that is something very unique that I've never really been able to see too much of. Like, there's a lot of really cool elements that are put into the show, whether it be out of magic. There's a lot of, like, almost bloodbending that's used in this show, and it's very gruesome. This show can get really bloody and brutal. People get chopped in half like it's nothing. People using their magic, like, they get their insides churned from, like, these bloodbenders that are in it. A lot of decapitations, people getting shot, knives in the back of their head. It's very gruesome, but it's very effective in the way that they do it. And like I said, trauma is taken into account with a lot of these characters. And there's a lot of it from the action and just the brutality that this world forces its characters to endure and even partake in to progress their own political landscapes, even just to survive a lot of the time. And the violence is very effective. It's not one of those just, how bloody and gory can we make this? Can we make this spectacle? It's nothing like that, which, again, is very kind of respectable to the horrors and the trauma that you're seeing on screen. And it's just done in a really effective way. The costume design in this show is fantastic too. I was blown away by just how high budget a lot of it looked, and the set pieces, all the castles, all the landscapes are really, really well done. The CGI for the creatures and the magic is really, really good. There's just so much that goes on in the show that was just making me happy to be a fan of fantasy series, and it's all just so effectively done, so well done, and it looks so good. The music is very, very well done too. Sound design is fantastic in this show too, whether it just be the sounds of the creatures, the sounds of the magic being used, and just lighting effects. Everything was just so well put out, where it felt like I was watching almost like a Hobbit level movie in terms of, like, a CGI budget in a Netflix series, which, again, props to Netflix for putting a lot of time, effort, and money into their shows, because it's really paying off with some incredible television that they've been able to put out, especially in their fantasy series in the last couple years here. But yes, as someone who's never read the books, I'm so intrigued and just so happy to have a new show and new characters that I could absolutely fall in love with and follow, and I can't wait to see more of what they can bring into this world and where the story is gonna go, and just, like, some really fantastic villains that were either just side villains, henchmen, no matter what they were, really good and really well-written villains, which, again, I'm really excited to see how they're gonna be able to top it in the next upcoming seasons, because of course it does set up for that. But with everything taken together, I have to give the first season of Shadowbone on Netflix an 8 out of 10. It was really fantastic, and it just has me craving more, wanting more, and I hope that we get it sooner than later, because it was just very well executed. And of course, if you've seen the first season of Shadow and Bone on Netflix, please let me know what you thought of it in the comments down below. And if you like this review, you can check out all my other TV reviews, movie reviews, everything I do on this channel through my playlist down below, and I'll link some up top here. If you like what you see on the channel, of course, you can subscribe and turn a little ringer on if you want to know when I upload new videos. There's everything video gaming that I do. There's a link to my Twitch in the bottom or in the description of this. And there's also a link to my Discord, which is the Media Mountain, where we talk about movies, video games, TV, comic books, basically everything that's awesome in this world, and just share our love and passion for media, and just, like I said, everything awesome. And yeah, definitely go check out Shadow and Bone on Netflix. 8 episodes long for the first season here, and it's just fantastic and awesome, guys.